Hello students, I am Satyaprakash. Welcome to Cars Physics. We are continuing chapter number 3, that is current electricity. Okay, and of course this is lecture number 3 on the chapter. Chapter 3 and lecture 3. Okay, in previous lecture, means in lecture 2, we have discussed the concept of drift velocity of free electrons in a conductor when the conductor is connected between the terminals of a cell. Okay, when a conductor is connected between terminals of a cell, say this is a conductor. Okay, it is connected between terminals of a cell or battery. This is a cell. So this is positive potential, positive terminal or positive potential and negative terminal. So potential difference between the terminals of the cell is V. Okay. Now the free electrons present in the conductor, tend to move from low potential to high potential, as we have discussed. Okay. When a conductor is connected between terminals of a cell, an electric field is established. Resultant electric field or net electric field is established inside the conductor, and direction of electric field is from high potential to low potential, means from positive to negative. So obviously the free electrons present in the conductor will experience force opposite to the direction of electric field. Okay, and we have discussed the concepts. In a good conductor, number density of free electrons, n is number density of free electrons. So that means number density means number of free electrons. Number of free electrons per unit volume of the conductor. Let's write this formula like this. N is the number density of free electrons. That's equals to number of free electrons per unit volume. Let N is the number of free electrons. V is volume. Okay. So volume. I will write VOL. Volume. Okay. So number density of free electrons in a good conductor is very high. Okay, so that number varies 10 to the power 28 per meter cube to anywhere, depending upon the nature of conductor. Say for copper, if you take copper, the number of free electrons means number density of free electrons is 10 to the power 29 per meter cube. And this power of 10 may vary depending upon the nature of material of the conductor. If you take silver, then this value will increase. If you take iron, then this value will decrease. Means power of 10 will decrease. Okay. Depending upon nature of material. Okay. Now, the free electrons present in the conductor, means the high number density of free electrons are present, will experience a resultant force opposite to the direction of electric field. So during their motion, they collide against each other. Okay, with each collision, the electrons lost kinetic energy. Thereafter, they start gaining kinetic energy. So we do say, average velocity of free electrons is called as drift velocity.
Okay. We have found the expression for drift velocity. E, of course, we have taken negative in vector form. E tau by m. Okay. E is electric field. Tau is average relaxation of time. E is charge of electron, and m is mass of electron. And again, we have found E v tau by mm. So here V is potential difference between the ends of conductor, which is connected between terminals of a cell, and L is total length of conductor.
So what we have concluded?
What we have concluded? Drift velocity directly proportional to
electric field intensity. Stronger the electric field, more is the drift velocity. Of course,
order of drift velocity.
Order of drift velocity is very small. We have discussed the concept in previous lecture, and I would like to invite the students who have not gone through lecture 2, go through it. We have discussed all the concepts, means how drift velocity is produced, what are the concepts behind drift velocity. Okay, go through it, and I hope your fundamental concept will be completely clarified. Okay, go through it fast. Okay, then stronger the electric field, more is drift velocity. Of course, value of order of drift velocity is very small, means varies from 10 to the power minus 3 meter per second to 10 to the power minus 5 meter per second and 10 to the power minus 3 meter per second. This order is very small. Okay, then drift velocity directly proportional to potential difference. Of course, electric field is dV by dr. So more the potential difference, more is the magnitude of electric field. Then drift velocity inversely proportional to length of conductor. Okay, and finally about the relaxation of time, since relaxation of time inversely proportional to temperature. Since relaxation of time inversely proportional to temperature, we have discussed this concept in previous lecture. So drift velocity inversely proportional to temperature. Okay, so more the temperature, more is collision, so average velocity will decrease. So drift velocity directly proportional to electric field, drift velocity directly proportional to potential difference, inversely proportional to length, and inversely proportional to temperature. With increase in temperature, magnitude of drift velocity decreases. Okay, then in two days class we will discuss. See, these are all important things I am writing here. Number density is the number of free electrons per unit volume. Number density is the number of free electrons per unit volume. Okay, this is highlight about previous lecture. Okay, then in this lecture we will discuss on the relation between current and drift velocity. Relation between current and drift velocity, we will discuss it first. And again, from very beginning, I would like to say, finally, we will discuss different important factors. On which current depends. Okay, these are very easier discussions, but what I have seen, many students sometimes get confused, though the concepts are very easier. Okay, let me find first the relation between current and drift velocity, and finally we will go to those important discussions, the factors how current changes or the factors on which current depends. Okay, first, 4, 3, 12, we have already discussed all this. Then, relation between current and drift velocity, let's consider. This is a closed path of conductor, means this conducting wire is connected between terminals of a cell, positive, negative, and potential difference is V. Okay? Total length of the conductor is L. Okay? Let's consider a part of conductor. This part is now, we are taking highlighted part. Okay. Let's bring this part. So, wire This is highlighted part. Okay. Cross sectional area. Here very small, looks very small. We have highlighted it. Let cross sectional area is A. Okay. Length of total conductor is L. Okay. Conductor contains high number density of free electrons. We are considering this part, means this much length of conductor. Okay. A part of conductor. But total length of the conductor is there, and cross sectional area, let uniform, uniform cross sectional area is A. Okay. This end is connected to positive, and this end is connected to negative terminal, and potential difference is V for all conductors. For all conductor, okay. Then this conductor contains high number density of free electrons. Okay, a part of conductor, the highlighted part, the highlighted part, a part of conductor is considered. Conductor contains a high number density of free electrons. So if the conductor is connected between terminals of a cell, all the free electrons experience force opposite to the direction of electric field established. External electric field or net electric field inside the conductor is established, which is directed from high potential to low potential, and direction of drift velocity is from low potential to high potential, means electrons are drifted opposite to the direction of electric field. Okay, electrons experience force. Force is equal to charge of electron into, means product of charge of electron and electric field intensity, and direction of force is from low potential to high potential. Obviously, all the free electrons will tend to move from low potential to high potential. Okay? So, current. Current is defined as rate of flow of charge. Quantity of charge, strength of current is defined as quantity of charge flowing per unit time. Quantity of charge flowing per unit time. Then, first we have to find what is magnitude of charge. Means, magnitude of charge of total electrons. Magnitude of charge of total free electrons present in the conductor. Present in the conductor, which is connected between terminals of a cell. Okay, so as per our general assumption, let n is number of free electrons per unit volume. Okay, then number of free electrons is number density, n is number density, number of free electrons per unit volume, then n into volume of the conductor. This is I am writing here, number of free electrons in the conductor is n is equal to number density into volume of conductor. Number density, product of number density and volume of conductor. Cross-sectional area of the conductor is A. Cross-sectional area of the conductor is A. And total length of the conductor is L. Cross-sectional area of the conductor is A. And total length of the conductor is L. Let's assume this is the whole length of conductor. Length is L. Let's assume we have taken this highlighted part. But actually, whole part, whole length of conductor is taken into account to get volume of the conductor. Okay. Then number of free electrons is n into volume. Volume is equal to area, means cross-sectional area, product of cross-sectional area and length of conductor. Okay. Cross-sectional area into length of conductor. Of course, if this is a cylindrical conductor wire, metallic wire, then cross-sectional area is circular. Okay. If the cylindrical conductor, means wire is taken, then cross-sectional area is. If cylindrical conductor is taken, then cross-sectional area is a circle. Square circle. Cross-sectional area is circle, and the area of this circular cross-section may be taken as pi r square. I have taken A. So number of free electrons is number density into volume. Volume is equal to area of cross section, product of area of cross section and length. Then total charge is Q. Q is equal to, in this case we may write N. Q is equal to N. N is the number of three electrons in the conductor. Okay, is N. Number of three electrons in the conductor is N. Then number of three electrons into charge of three electrons. A charge of electron, then total charge is N A L E. In place of number of three electrons, we can write N A L. Again, charge of electron is E. This is charge of electron. See, drift velocity of three electrons is V D. Let's assume it's constant. Let's assume it's uniform. Okay. We have already discussed the dependence of drift velocity. Okay. If all these vectors are taken to be constant at a given temperature, at a particular potential difference, okay, at a given value of the electric field, then drift velocity may be assumed to be constant. If drift velocity is constant, then time taken by the free electrons to move from low potential to high potential is time is distance divided by speed. Time is the distance divided by speed. Okay. So the conductor, inside the conductor there is a number of electrons, means number density of three electrons is very high. Okay. If we consider, suppose electrons are drifted to this part, to this saddle part, then in some time, then obviously the electrons just behind this part will move into it when this part will transfer further. First electron start moving from this negative terminal inside the conductor. Let's take this point. Then electrons move, means electrons are pushed towards positive. This section is pushed towards this. Then this part of electron is pushed to this part of electron, this part, then further in this part the electrons will move forward and finally cross the positive terminal. So electrons are packed inside the conductor. In different cross-sectional areas, electrons pass. Since density is very high, electrons are packed. So This part is transferred till the whole electrons, means starting from negative terminal, from final end to this end. Okay, from this end to this end, all the electrons pass in time t. So total distance is L. Then time is the distance divided by speed. Speed means magnitude of drift velocity. Now. Current is equal, this is the formula, charge upon time, then current is equal to, in place of charge we can write N A L E, divided by time is L divided by V, L will get cancelled, then current is equal to N A E V, current is equal to N A E V. This is the formula of current relation to drift velocity. We discuss different factors on the basis of this formula. This is very important formula. Okay, we will find such questions or objective based questions, and also we will get numericals using this formula. Very easy. Okay, but the concept you have to understand. Okay, now I am erasing all this. We have got the formula. Then, relation between current and drift velocity is given as I is equal to NAEVD. We have got it. Okay, now our discussion. Very easy and very conceptual. Current depends upon which factors? This formula will tell us this formula will tell us current depends upon which factor. See, current directly depends upon number density of free electrons. Current directly depends upon number density of free electrons. Number density of free electrons means number of free electrons per unit volume of substance. Okay. Number density of free electrons depends upon nature of material of the conductor. As we have discussed, if we take silver, which is best conductor among all solid conductors, silver is best conductor. Then silver has high value of number density of free electrons. Thereafter we will take copper. Thereafter we will take aluminium. Okay. So depending upon nature of material, number density varies. For silver, number density of free electrons is maximum. Thereafter for copper, thereafter for aluminium, and so on. So first point we may write current depends upon nature of conductor or nature of material of conductor. Nature of material of conductor. Very important. Nature of material of conductor. Okay. Second, current directly proportional to area of cross section. Current directly proportional to area of cross section means current depends upon area of cross section of the conductor. Of the conductor. Then number three, charge of electron is constant. We may say current is directly proportional to drift velocity. Okay, more the drift velocity, more is current. But we know, drift velocity inversely proportional to temperature. Drift velocity inversely proportional to temperature. Again, current directly proportional to temperature. So we are discussing for a conductor. For a conductor, current inversely proportional to temperature. Current depends upon temperature, and current inversely proportional to temperature. Thus we may write current depends upon temperature of conductor. Current depends upon temperature of conductor. Thus current depends upon nature of material, area of cross section, temperature. Okay, depends upon temperature. So finally here I may write current depends upon nature of material. Okay, area of cross section of conductor, and finally current depends upon temperature of the conductor. Current depends upon nature of material, area, and temperature. Okay, this is generalized discussion. Okay, I am erasing it. Now see the formula. For a given conductor, n is constant. Means number density of free electrons is constant, which depends upon nature of material. For a given conductor, n is constant. Again, E is charge of electron, which is constant. Then basically, current depends upon, from the formula as we see, current depends upon the product of area and drift velocity. Current depends upon area, product of area and drift velocity. For a given conductor, n is constant, charge of electron is constant. If I is considered to be uniform or constant, if current is taken to be constant, a constant current flowing in a conductor, then product of area and drift velocity is constant. Product of area and drift velocity is constant. This implies drift velocity inversely proportional to area of cross section of the conductor. Okay, you know it. So in fluid in motion, you have studied fluid in motion. In fluid in motion, we do obey the flow of continuity. The product of area of cross section and velocity of flow of liquid in a pipe is constant. Where area is small, velocity is more, and vice versa. Where area is more, their velocity is small, and vice versa. We know it. Okay? Then, this is the concept. Then, what we have discussed, current depends upon area of cross section of a conductor. Current depends upon area of cross section of a conductor. We have got the relation. Now I will find the beautiful concept, very important concept. See, current depends upon area of cross section for a given conductor. For a given conductor, current is independent of area of cross section. This is very important. You see, current depends upon area of cross section. This is generalized discussion. But for a given conductor, current is independent of area of cross section. This is the fact behind that. How? Well, explain. Okay. Suppose this is a conductor of non-uniform cross section. Okay. So let's assume the conventional flow of charge, positive charge, is flowing from positive to negative. This is area of cross section A1, this is area of cross section A2, this is area of cross section A3, and so on. Here area is small, so drift velocity is more. Here area is some extent more, and drift velocity is small, and so on. So where area increases, cross sectional area increases, drift velocity decreases, and vice versa. Here, from these two cross sectional areas, we may see VB2 is less than VB1. Here area is more, so drift velocity is small. So product of area and drift velocity for a given conductor, remains constant. Again, N is fixed for a given conductor and charge of electron is constant, thus current is constant. So for a given conductor, current is independent of area of cross section, very important. Okay. Next, another part. In electrostatics, we have discussed there is no electric field inside a conductor, but here, when current flows in a conductor, there must be electric field. There must be electric field inside the conductor. This concept we have already discussed. Okay, in previous lecture, go through it. Those who have not gone through previous lecture 2, go through it. We have discussed this concept, how electric field is established inside a conductor. Okay, net electric field inside a conductor is not zero if the conductor is connected between terminals of a cell. Okay, then another important point, a conductor. So sometimes teachers ask question like this. This is a conductor in which current is flowing. Question is like that, very easy question. Does the conductor is charged when current flows through it? No. So a conductor remains uncharged when current flows When current flows through a conductor remains uncharged. See, in very simpler way, just see here. Okay. Suppose this is a conductor connected between terminals of a cell. Okay. Then conventional flow of current is from positive to negative, or electronic current is from negative to positive. So the conductor is connected between the terminals of a cell or battery, which is source of EMF. Battery is not source of charge. Battery is not source of charge. Or cell is not source of charge. Cell is source of energy. The free electrons present inside the conductor experience force due to the source of EMF or cell. So these free electrons which are already inside the conductor tend to move from low potential to high potential. So of course you know in electrostatics a substance is said to be charged if it either loses or gains electron. So battery is not source of charge. So when current flows through a conductor, there is no gain or loss of electron by the conductor. So the conductor remains uncharged when current flows through it. So this is basic concept in today's lecture we have discussed the relation between current and drift velocity and various factors related to current and drift velocity. Okay, this is end of lecture 3. Again in next lecture I will meet you with some beautiful concepts. Thanks, my dear children. Thanks.